It's episode 15 of season 3 of the Twilight Zone. This one is called A Quality of Mercy. Last time out, we had 5 characters in search of an exit, which was an episode, interesting episode. There were 5 characters, and they were searching for an exit. Did they find the exit? I don't know. You'll have to watch it. You'll have to see. This one, A Quality of Mercy. I presume it's going to deal with mercy of some sort. Maybe it'll be like the Magic Sand episode. Maybe it'll be something else. We won't know until we get into it. Maybe one of the qualities of mercy is that everybody dies. Mercy killings. That's not going to be what it is. But I've been wrong before. Remember episodes 22 and 33? Okay. Ooh, it's the war. Isn't this close to the end of the war? It's very close to the end of it, right?
Short. That's right, still.
Launch it further.
They say that's their limit.
Damn it, move them closer then. Move the launchers closer. Were you in a different episode?
Yeah, we can bypass it.
He was in a different episode.
Anybody back there figure out how long it takes the enemy to die of insomnia?
He's got singers. A couple niners.
If they can't smoke them out, maybe we'll bypass it.
Yeah.
Well, that's what I like to hear.
I've got no big yen to run into anything anymore, not at this stage of the game.
Hey, this guy. Is that Leonard Nimoy? I wasn't looking at him until I was looking at this guy, who I recognize from a different episode.
Look at them. They're in there, holed up in that cave, beaten, sick, and yet there's no one in there to tell them that the war's over for them.
The last grimy pages of a dirty, torn book of war.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's so Leonard Nimoy.
I'm Lieutenant Cattell. I'm taking over the platoon.
All right.
What's your situation here, Sergeant?
Well, we've got these guys in the cave, and...
Cave down there. Bunch of Japs holed up in it. We've been trying to get them out of there.
Trying to flush them out.
Nothing doing.
They just won't move. Are we sure they're in there? Yeah, that's a cave, all right. Looks like we're firing a bit short.
Looks like we'll have to do a little mopping up by ourselves.
Oh, we have to go in there?
Just move right in there and wipe them out.
But...
Hey, Lieutenant.
Dude.
You sure you got the right platoon? Begging the lieutenant's pardon, sir, but...
You're out of your mind.
Just inherited a pretty good outfit, but we're not that good.
I told you he had the wrong platoon.
Your name is what, soldier?
My name is Watkins.
Watkins,
are you accustomed to talking to an officer lying on your back?
Well, you're 12 years old, dude. You want me to risk my life going into that cave?
When you talk to an officer, you stand up on your two feet.
And you say, sir?
Yes, Lieutenant, we haven't had much sleep.
You have my sympathy, Sergeant. My job is to lead this platoon. I intend to lead it my way.
He's no nonsense.
When I tell you boys to jump, you'll jump.
You can see why he got promoted. So young.
What are your orders, Lieutenant?
I think we'll have to move up and then go right in there and wipe them out.
What do you think, Sergeant?
You asking my opinion, Lieutenant?
I'm willing to discuss it.
We lost 3 platoon officers because they made slight motions of commands with their hands. And that's what the Japs look for. The guy in command.
Now what about attacking the cave?
Well,
maybe we'll have to do it eventually, but the war isn't going to end before dinner time.
It's pretty close.
But it strikes me we could move in there and wipe them out inside of an hour.
Lieutenant, how long have you been out here? But you talk like it's a football game, and this is no football game, Lieutenant. You have to remember, Lieutenant, you haven't been shot at yet, and you haven't shot anybody either.
When it comes to killing Japanese, I think you'll find me a pretty efficient officer.
He's pretty confident. We'll see.
I want clean weapons in this platoon because we're going to kill Japs. That's my job. This outfit better shape up.
Yes, sir.
This one is bloodthirsty.
You don't think you'll want us to scalp him?
Shh. He can hear you.
You're tired of killing Japs, is that it? Or have you just got no stomach for it?
Now, we've seen enough dead men to last us for the rest of our lives.
Yeah.
the rest of our lives, Lieutenant, and then some. Now, you got a big yen to do some killing? Okay.
You go in there.
But don't ask us to stand up and cheer.
I don't know, I think a few more days of being bombarded, the cave will just collapse on its own. This is me, just before I start my reactions. I figured out who he is. He's the guy from the execution. He's going to be hanged, but then he got...
Check with company about the time of the next mortar barrage. We'll move in there. You're going to have to double time this one, Sergeant. That is, if you're going to keep up with me.
Sure thing.
I'm not your cup of tea, am I, Sergeant?
You're a bit...
A little bit too much vinegar for me, Lieutenant.
Vinegar. That's good.
Look, we could bypass them. They're sick and half-starved.
But they're Japs.
They're men, Lieutenant.
Well, forgive me an observation. If I had to size you up, I'd say you've either got battle fatigue or you're chicken.
What's your problem? You have no natural leadership qualities.
The way I size you...
Go ahead, Sergeant. How do you size me up?
You're green. You've got no...
You're a pea-green shavetail just fresh from some campus.
Yes.
You want to prove your manhood, but it's a little late in the day.
You're a lousy soldier, Corserano. And that goes for the rest of these boys you want me to bottle feed.
Mm-hmm.
Did somebody forget to tell you when you fight a war, you fight a war?
Right, I got your message, Lieutenant. And there's always someone like you that sneaks
Ooh,
in
he's
before
lost
they
it.
Close the door to...
Insubordination.
How many men have to die before you're satisfied?
Offhand, I'd say all of them. If they're the enemy, they get it. First day of the war or last day of the war, they get it.
No mercy is his motto. Oh no, not the... Why was there a big noise about that?
Lieutenant Yamuri, you dropped your glasses, sir.
What the hell? Whoa! Did he just become a Japanese officer? Did he just morph into an alternate universe? Are there Americans in the cave? Where are you going? You're gonna get yourself killed. Go back! What were you thinking, Lieutenant? Just running it at the cave? It's a bold move. I wouldn't have done it.
Lieutenant Yamuri, sir.
You're so brave.
That was exceedingly brave, sir. Single-handedly.
Those are Americans in the cave?
Yeah, we're winning. Sir. We've just about won the war.
I figure there are 20 or 30 of them.
There's only a few
Most
left.
Most of them wounded.
You feel,
are you all right?
Feeling okay?
Sir?
You don't look yourself.
Where are we? Are you feeling well?
I ask you a question. Where are we?
Corregidor, sir.
When?
May 4th.
It's August.
Humbly ask the lieutenant to forgive me, but I must correct him.
You're crazy, Lieutenant.
May 4th, 1942. Is...
No. No. What's going on? What happened?
It was the time binoculars.
We shall be moving out shortly, and if you're too ill to move, we shall leave you here.
Leave me here?
Something's happened. My name is not Yamuri. My name is...
Don't say it. It's Yamuri. That's who I am.
I was feverish for a moment. I'm all right now.
Yeah.
You sure?
Yes, sir.
Good to go.
Very sure. We move out in 5 minutes. We will attack the cave in force. You will take the first section. Move forward as quickly as you can. We will cover you with automatic fire for 2 or 3 minutes before you make the actual attack.
Okay.
Understood?
Got it. Maybe it'll... change his perspective?
You said there were wounded in there.
It shouldn't be too difficult.
What did you just say?
There are wounded in there, sir. Perhaps we can let them surrender. Or perhaps we can leave them there. Bypass them.
Yeah, just leave them alone.
They are enemy. Healthy, wounded, walking or lying. The Japanese army wipes out its opponents.
Okay.
They're wounded and beaten.
Odd that you should require this reminder. They are enemy. And this is war. And in war, you kill. You kill until you are ordered to stop killing.
Ooh, he's using his own words against him.
Killing. No!
Get out of here with your mercy. Grab the time, the alternate universe binoculars. Throw them on the ground.
We move out.
Snap out of it, man. We gotta get back to 1945.
I will take care of you when we return.
How many must die before he's satisfied?
Offhand, Lieutenant Yamuri. I would say all of them.
All of them? It's your words, again.
First day of the war, last day of the war, we destroy them.
Exactly, dude. Well, what do you think of that? Come on, let's get back to 1945. So I was thinking, fellas, let's just...
Anytime you say, Lieutenant.
Just ask them for surrender. That's what we should do.
Anytime you say, Lieutenant, form lines for the duck shoot.
Hey, I'm American again. Lieutenant, you feeling okay? You don't seem as bloodthirsty as...
Casarano.
Earlier.
Orders, Lieutenant, they want us off the hill. The Air Force dropped a bomb in Japan this morning.
Oh, it's...
A big one.
Ooh.
They call it an atomic bomb.
It's the end.
All right, on your feet, everybody.
Let's get out of here.
Get ready to move out of here. You with us, Lieutenant?
What do you say, Lieutenant?
Yeah, I'm with you.
What is it, something, Lieutenant?
Bang my head or something? Made me a better person?
Yeah, something.
There'll be other caves, other wars, other human beings you can knock off.
Yeah, you'll get to kill more people if you wanna.
God help us, I hope not. The quality of mercy is not strained.
Ooh, it's a quote. Place beneath. It's a quote.
It blesseth him that gives and him that takes. Shakespeare, the Merchant of Venice.
Yeah. Dean Stockwell! I knew he looked familiar. Dean Stockwell. From Quantum Leap. His face is so familiar. So, interesting little twist in this episode. The gung-ho, we're going to kill everybody. I don't care if it's the last day of the war. I don't care if the war is over. We're going to kill them. That guy gets completely... He's like, okay, how about we change your perspective a little? How about we change sides and see how you feel about that? And he very quickly learned his lesson. He was very quickly kind of going, yeah, but they're kind of injured in that cave. And, you know, maybe we shouldn't kill them. What do you think about that? It's interesting how quickly your opinions and perspectives can change when you're thrust into the other side. Like, it never happens in real life, but if you were to be thrust into the other, your team versus their team sort of thing, how quickly you can start, your brain can start thinking in different ways. It was just to teach him a lesson about mercy and about why he's really there. The guy, the sergeant, he was right on the money. The guy was green. He was out to prove himself. He didn't want to, you know, he wanted to show the admiralty that he had what it takes, you know, up the ladder as quickly as possible. Here to do a job, we're going to kill them all, you know. Without, he didn't have that experience that the rest of the team had. They were kind of war weary and a little less gung-ho. They were doing the job that they'd been asked to do, but they didn't have to be happy about it, you know, that sort of thing. And then he's just there kind of going, go, 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 clean your, what are you doing with this rifle? It's not clean, or, you know, that sort of thing. Like it was the first day, you know. Dean Stockwell, that's good. It's like everybody who's anybody has been in the Twilight Zone, seems like. And Leonard Nimoy, just a nobody extra, you know? He had like two lines in the whole thing. And so recognizable, that face. Ooh, imagine if it was another Buster Keaton situation where I completely didn't notice it at all until the start of the next episode. Yeah, that would have been funny. So I was wrong. A Quality of Mercy. Not the worst episode of The Twilight Zone. Not by a long shot. You all know which one is the worst. I don't have to tell you that. And that guy was definitely the guy from... the other episode. Yeah, the execution episode. I'm definitely going to miss a ton of connections. And as I watch more and more shows from this era, those connections will be even more. You know, if I'd watched other shows of this era first and then jumped into the Twilight Zone, I'd say almost every single episode I'd be like, hey, there's that guy from Lost in Space, there's that guy from the I Love Lucy show. Hey, there's that person from, you know, those side. There's Laurel and Hardy. What are they doing here? Ooh, look, there's Buster Keaton. So, Equality and Mercy. Nice little episode. Next time out, we have... Ooh, Nothing in the Dark. Nothing in the Dark. What's in the dark? Do you hear that? Just out there in the dark, what is it? It's nothing. Is it? Why don't you go out there and check it out? Why don't you go down to that basement and check out the darkness? There's nothing there. Maybe it's space. The dark reaches of space. Ooh, nothing. Or maybe it's, as I always say, maybe it's just a metaphor. Yeah, come back next time for that. Until then, have a lovely time. And the next time you get annoyed at your next door neighbor who's playing the bagpipes, just think, you could be the bagpipe player. You could be living there. You could just be really enjoy the music or the instrument, you know? You know, change your perspective, maybe. Don't be all about you. See you next time.